Shalom YouTube, this is your Ark. Yah is magnified, coming back with another informative video as always. This video is titled, More Proof That Corporations Are People. So with that being said, let's get to it. But before we go any further, I'd like to state as always, I'm not a lawyer, I do not practice law, and I do not pretend to. All my videos are for informational and educational purposes only. You know, and they're all facts. That's it. That's all. So with that being said, let's get to it. Okay, guys. So I have a recording from my arc, man. He went into court. He stood on his square. He did good, man. You know, he created his own paperwork and he just, you know, he's learning, you know, and he wanted to do this on his own. So I applaud him for that, man. He's doing it on his own. He's learning, you know, he's becoming his own teacher too, because he's learning. He's doing it on his own. You know, and I respect that, you know. And like I said, but he wanted to donate as well. But I know he got this. So I said, man, I'm not going to charge you a thing, you know. You got this. You can do this. You know, for one, you're not even in the system, you know. My whole goal is to help guys get out of the system. He's not even in the system yet. You know, they're trying to get him into the system. So, you know, he got that fight. I know he got this fight. I believe in him. The brother's a powerful young man, man. Very intelligent, smart young man. He got this, you know. But he had sent me this video, I mean this recording of him in court yesterday. He tried to call me before he went in, but I missed his phone call. And by the time I called him back, he was already in there. I wish I would have spoke to him before. But he still did good, man. He did wonderful, man. That's my arc, man. He did good, man. I'm proud of him. You know, his fight not over yet. You know, he didn't sign no documents or none of that. So he go back to court and he's got to continue to stand on the square, you know. But he got this, you know. I know he got this. He going to walk away free. But besides all that, guys, you know, I want you guys to hear this magistrate clearly tell him that corporations are people. Now, if corporations are people, then that also means people who think they are people, they're truly corporations. You see what I mean, guys? So they're not talking to you as a man or a woman, man. They're talking to you as a fictitious entity, a straw man, you know. That's it. That's all. Once you guys see that and stand up on your square on that, man, you know, get that proper understanding, you guys will be able to go in there, fight, stand on your square, and win. You know, it's no losses, man. Only time you lose is when you stop fighting. You know what I mean? That's the only time you guys lose, when you stop fighting. But with that being said, now let's listen in to this. I don't want to wrap y'all up too much, but let's listen to this.
So you wrongfully just took my Social Security number?
Yeah, it's in the system. It's not wrongful. I've got it in the system.
Okay, so he stated to the magistrate. So you're just going to wrongfully take my Social Security number. Obviously, that means he never gave it to him. How did they get it? But she's going to explain to you guys how she received his Social Security number. Man, these people, man, you know, man, come on, man. They wicked, man. You know, wickedness, man. Like the Bible says, man, you're not fighting against flesh and blood, man. You're fighting against wickedness in high places, man. These people are high in high places, are wicked, man. You know what I mean? They're cold wicked. But let's finish listening to my man standing there fighting down on the square.
Employers are required to report information for tax purposes, particularly like this system. It's called the Maryland Automated Benefits Wage History Inquiry. We call it MABS. What it is that your employers are required to submit information for
That's
tax purposes.
They don't have to do that.
Well, they do, because they file their own taxes. Like, businesses file taxes just like individuals do, because apparently some legislators think that companies are people.
Did you guys just hear that? She just said legislators believe that companies are people. Same thing I've been telling you guys over and over and over again. Let's go back and hear her say that again real quick.
This is just like individuals do, because apparently some legislators think that companies are people. But
so you hear that, guys? So she said it again. Okay, but let's continue to move forward from there. Now, let's see how they wickedly go into this man's personal information and take his money, basically, or try to take his money. But he blocked that, so yeah. But let's go and see how they basically try to get his personal information, you know, by just going into the system. Hold on.
This is just like individuals do, because apparently some legislators think that companies are people. But regardless, when they file taxes, part of what they need to do is list their expenses. One of the main expenses, of course, is what they pay out to employees, like overhead type things. So we're able to access that kind of information for what companies are paying out to their employees. So because y'all are both, you know, you worked for places that report, we're able to get your information. So it's not wrongful at all. It's completely on the up and up.
Oh, yeah, agency or
for everyone. I mean,
no,
for
it doesn't benefit me or my children.
I mean, you work for an American company, you have to follow American laws.
No, that's not true.
You hear that, guys? So like he said it ain't benefiting him, it's benefiting the company. That's it. That's all, you know. So shout out to my Ark again, man, for sending me this recording. You know, it's longer than that, but you know, we're not gonna go all the way through this whole thing. You know, I know you guys probably wanted to hear the ending. But if you know, basically what happened in the ending was they moved him up to another court. He have to go before another judge. That's it. That's all. So he gonna continue to fight. He gonna stand in the square and do what he got to do. He said he don't got nothing but fight left in him, and that's how it's gonna go. You know, so we gonna keep it moving. You know, I'm gonna continue to help my arc out. You know, any way I can. You know, cause the guy, man, he's proven that he really want to fight, and he's a soldier, man. Not even I can't even say a soldier, man, cause you know when you look that up, man, it's not a good thing to be a soldier, neither. You know, so do your research on that word later too, guys, when you got free time. But as I stated, man, you know, everything they're doing to us is just wrong because they don't see you as a live person. You can't be a living man or woman when you're dealing with these people. They see you as a fictitious entity that they can just do whatever they want to and store you in their warehouses and everything else. But let's continue to go a little bit further. I want you guys to listen to other things, but so hold on for one quick second.
But as you will learn, government is a creation of man. And a creation of man can never be above man. They always need your consent, and this is where your power really lies. With knowledge always comes power. The power not to fear. The power to take a stand against anyone or any corporation that threatens you. The power to say no. It has been said that you need to know that you're in a cage before you can escape from that cage. Let's look into how you're being tricked and how your power has been hidden from you. If you've never heard of the terms legal fiction or straw man, then what you're about to learn is something that sounds so astonishing that it couldn't possibly be true. If I were to tell you that paying your tax, getting a driver's license, registering your car, paying fines, and attending court are all optional and that you are conned into agreeing with them, what would you think? All statutes and acts are optional too. Your straw man is a fictitious legal entity created at your birth through your birth certificate and the registration of that birth.
Okay, my understanding of the legal fiction, which is also referred to as a straw man, the way I explain it when I do talks, I keep it really, really simple. And what I do, I liken it to a game of Monopoly. Now, in a game of Monopoly, you actually have a little token, like a dog or a battleship or a hat, you know, like a little top hat, and you move it around the board. Now, I believe that they actually give us a fictional entity which we can actually use or not use. And I believe this is the, and a lot of other researchers do as well, that this is your name in either uppercase or with a title.
But when each person is born, whenever a human being is born, there's two entities. One is the real entity, which is the human being, the flesh and blood. And the other is a legal fiction, a fictional entity that is nothing more than a piece of paper, the birth certificate. Again, we're duped into believing that these are one in the same. And so we're tricked into representing the legal fiction, the straw man, that birth certificate. So when people get fines and things like that, It's actually consulting the legal fiction, the non-existent entity, the corporate entity that is owned by corporations.
You have any interactions with the bureaucracy, okay? They're not interacting with you. They're actually interacting with your legal fiction, because they can't deal with a flesh and blood human. Yeah, they have to deal with another corporation.
When you start to break down the words that we use, and you start to look at the roots of all these words, and you actually look at what these words actually really mean, you start to get an idea of what's going on. The word corporation is very, very specific, because it's corp and oration, it's dead speak. So a corporation is something that's dead. It's an entity that exists only in a legal framework. It doesn't exist in any other framework at all. It only becomes an entity through legal mechanisms and legal means.
In essence, when you were born and far too young to understand, a company with your name was created through your birth certificate. When your parents registered your birth, they actually created a company and handed ownership of that company and you over to the state. It is important to remember that your parents were tricked and had no ideas was happening. This is why the state can take children from their families and it not be classed as kidnapping. They own your child.
They own one tenth, because they registered the child, they have nine tenths, possession is nine tenths of the law, but they still, there's one tenth floating about somewhere, and the government have claimed that one tenth. So when the child, because I've had it from social workers, many, at least now three social workers on separate occasions have come out of audiences and actually said to me, you're right in what you're saying, is because we have to get the birth certificate within 48 hours of taking the child. And if they can't get the birth certificate, they have to reapply to be able to get the birth certificate. They have to get it, because that is proof of who the slave is, what the slave is. And actually, in legal terms, they're actually only entitled to the birth certificate and not the child. To take the child on the pretense that they are this legal personality is theft. So in legal terms, it's kidnapping. But the social services can use legal kidnapping, because everything is okay as long as it has the stamp legal applied to it. That includes war, genocide, anything is okay as long as it's legal.
The same thing also happens when you register your car. You get a document back saying you are the registered keeper and not the registered owner.
So yeah, obviously we've just spoken about registering children, and the other thing that we register though is our vehicles, and obviously either of those can allegedly be taken off you at some point in time, which is quite interesting. The two registered items are the things that can be taken.
You're the registered keeper of your car. You're not the owner, you're the keeper in their eyes. Now they'll argue that point, and a lot of people will argue that point, but it's quite easy to quell this argument and say, well, okay, if you don't put tax on the car, then they'll come and take your car. Now, in the legal world, taking anything from someone without a legal mechanism to do so is theft.
The legal system cannot deal with humans. It can only deal with pieces of paper. Only common law can deal with humans. So at your birth, they created a piece of paper with your name on it, in capitals, just like any other corporation. This is done to dupe you later in life into thinking that you are the legal entity and not you. Then imaginary penalties and cost are imposed on the straw man, and you, thinking you're it, pay them.
And it's kind of like an overcoat, this legal fiction. As soon as you put it on, as soon as they invite you to put this overcoat on, and you do so, now they can grab hold of the overcoat and throw it in jail with you in it. But until you put that overcoat on, they can't do anything to you, because you are not that name. You know, you think you are. You know, you're taught you are, but you're not.
The deception is done through the manipulation of words and language.
But
but that to me is legalese. It's just jargon that no one really understands, and because no one really understands it, no one ever questions it. We basically have a discussion that everybody is taught incorrect, but because everybody's taught incorrect, they believe it's correct.
Legalese is a whole language of its own. It's a complete legal jargon that's not really designed for anybody to understand it other than those that are supposedly supposed to be enforcing it. And it's something that's so complicated that not even police officers understand what they're saying.
What is wonderful is that they create their own language called legalese. And it has a completely different interpretation from English. You know, we're supposed to have, you know, this sort of understanding that we were within the law, and yet they're not even using the same language as we are.
The easiest way to understand legalese is to realize that there are many English words that have more than one meaning, depending on whom you are talking to. If I were to ask you what a person was, you'd probably say a human being. But that's you or I. If you were talking to someone in the law society, i.e. a police officer, lawyer, judge, etc., they have a different dictionary to you or I, and person could mean company or corporation, i.e. the legal fiction.
You know, if you tell a lie often enough, it becomes truth, or certainly the perception of truth. So legalese is jargon that nobody understands other than those who actually come up with a jargon that really, really deeply understand it. And even police officers don't understand it, or magistrates, or even judges for that matter.